the January is equal to challenge, and today's question is longest palindromic substring. In this question, you are given a string and you need to tell the longest palindromic substring that is present in that string. So the brute force algorithm, how do we go about it? You generate all possibilities of the substrings from a given string S, and for each string you check whether it is palindromic in nature or not. Store it in a variable which will be your answer, longest palindromic substring variable, and whenever you find a larger length substring which is palindromic in nature, you update that variable. The total time complexity for this approach is order of n cube, because the generation of all substrings would take order of n square, and for each substring you will check again whether it is palindromic in nature, which will be on its complete length. So the total time complexity is order of n square into order of n, which is order of n cube. This is a poor man solution or the brute force solution, which should be the first line of action when you hear this question, because this is how a regular programmer would think about it. Now the interviewer will ask, can you improvise on this solution? The answer is yes. How? The answer lies within the question itself. So, in the previous case, we multiplied generation of all substrings into with checking whether it is palindromic or not, and hence it resulted in increased time complexity of order of n cube. Can we think smarter and do something while we are generating the substrings, and the checking part can be done within itself? So, let's walk through an example and you will understand what I am talking about. So, we start with each index. And with each index as our starting point, I'll move in both the directions, the left direction and the right direction, treating the current character, current position, as the median of my palindromic substring. So let's assume that I'm at this pointer, the starting index 0, and I'll extend in both directions, the towards the right boundary and towards the left boundary, until I reach both the boundaries or I don't see a palindromic substring. And till the time I'll store it in a variable which will be my longest palindromic substring variable, which will store the length and my starting position from where that string is actually starting. So starting position is the starting position from my longest palindromic substring, and the longest palindromic substring length is then in a variable. So let's start the iteration. I'm at 0th index. I'm at the boundary. I'll not do anything. I'll update the starting position as 0. And longest palindromic substring is of one length. Then I move ahead and I am at the next index. Considering this as my start, as the middle point of my longest palindromic substring, I'll move in both directions. So I'll move towards the left boundary and the right boundary, and I saw that both the ends are equal, both the positions, the left index and the right index are equal. That means it is palindromic. And then again, so I update this variable, the longest palindromic substring length becomes equal to 3. And the starting position is again 0, gets updated to 0 by virtue of this. And I try moving beyond this. I reach the left boundary and I can't do anything. So this iteration is completed. Now let me just take another pen. And now I'm at the second boundary, and let's see whether I can generate a palindromic substring from this or not. So I'm at this position. I take two pointers. One pointer moves in this direction, another moves in towards the right boundary. One moves towards the left boundary. The value is equal. This might get updated, might not get updated, because it is of equally competing longest palindromic substring ABA. So you don't need to update it, although it's a valid contender for it. And SP still remains the same because it is not greater, but however it is equal to it. And we again move in both the directions. So we get B and here we get D, and these are not equal. We abort the process. Similarly, we next start from another next pointer. and we are here at the third position, and we check whether the longest palindromic substring for this part would be of length 1, because these characters are not equal, and this is lower than the LPS, can't do anything, move ahead. We encounter D, and we start from this position. Assuming that this is the current string, is of length 1, so it is lower than the LPS that we have previously found out. So we'll not update its position, and we are already at the terminal right boundary. We are done with this logic. We assumed in this iteration that my current index, lowest palindromic substring is of odd length. What you need to do, you also need to consider the cases where it is an even length longest palindromic substring. Let's walk through that example as well. So let's assume B, A, A, B. This is my string, input string, and I need to consider both the positions. So what does it mean? The current position and the starting position, next position. So these are like even length longest palindromic substring. So you'll be starting from this, the ith position and I plus 1 position, and then you will start the iteration. Obviously, you need to compare these two first, and then you will move one in right direction and this one in left direction for each part. So the overall time complexity reduces by order of n, as for each index you are considering it as one possibility as an odd length longest palindromic substring. You'll move across the boundaries till the boundaries, and the other part is considering the case where it is an even length palindromic substring. Whenever you find a longer contender for longest palindromic substring, you update this variable and update the starting position. Similarly, for the other case as well, I and I plus 1 case, where you are assuming that the longest palindromic substring is of even length. So let's quickly code this up. Create two global variables. One is private max length LPS equals to 0. And other is the starting point of my longest palindromic substring, which is also initialized to 0 in this case. If my length is less than equal to 1, that means it's 0 or 1, I'll simply return that string, because I don't need to do any computation on that. Otherwise, I will start the iteration from the 0th index up till the last index, and I'll increment I++, and let's consider the case where we are considering the ith index to be the middle point of our longest palindromic substring, and then we move in both the directions. What I'm trying to say is extend in both, check for longest palindromic substring in both the directions. So it will pass S as the current string, the starting point, for moving in the left direction, the starting point for moving in the right direction. And let me just write this method first so that you understand it better. String S, integer left start, let's call it left, integer right, because this signifies this is moving in the left direction, and this signifies this is moving in the right direction. And while left is greater than or equal to 0 and right is less than equal to s dot length, is less than s dot length, and s dot char at left equals to s dot char at right, I decrement the left index and I'll increment the right index. Once this loop breaks, either by virtue of being a non-palindromic string or we have reached the boundaries, we'll check if मैक्स लेंथ इज लेस देन राइट माइनस लेफ्ट माइनस वन. इफ दैट इज द केस बिकॉज दिस इज द करंट लेंथ ऑफ द मैक्सिमम पैलिंड्रोमिक सबस्ट्रिंग, वी अपडेट मैक्स लेंथ एल पी एस टू राइट माइनस लेफ्ट माइनस वन एंड द स्टार्टिंग पोजिशन स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट टू लेफ्ट प्लस वन. We consider, let's go back to the original logic. We considered that it is an odd length palindromic substring. We have to do a similar kind of a thing for an even length palindromic substring, and we start from I plus 1 position. And once we are done with this, we'll simply return the substring s dot substring start substring. The starting index would be the starting point and the ending index would be max length lps plus starting point. Starting point plus max length lps should, it should have been. And let me just try and submit this code. Compilation error s dot length. Looks good. Accepted. Let me just walk you through the algorithm again. What we have assumed, that I is the current point from which we need to check in both the directions, left and right, and identify the longest palindromic substring that is possible, with I being the starting, the middle point of the longest palindromic substring. One for odd length, another one for even length. How are we checking that? We accept three parameters in this: the string, the left point, the left index where we start, and the right index where we start. Left moved in the left direction, L minus minus. Right moved in the right direction towards the right boundary, right plus plus. And we keep on checking this till the time we either don't hit the boundaries, or the string becomes non-palindromic. Once we are out of this loop, we check for the current length. What is the current length? If the current length is greater than your maximum length LPS, we update the maximum length LPS and update the starting point. Otherwise, it remains the same. And once we are done with both, for both the cases, odd length palindromic substring or even length palindromic substring, we generate the new string, the new substring using this starting point and the max length that we calculated. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. The time complexity for this approach is order of n square. So TC is order of n square and SC is order of 1, constant time. There's another approach to solve this by dynamic programming. That would be an extension to this approach itself. I'll be making a video shortly on that.